and welcome to Video Vagrancy. I'm Doctor Sleaze, and with me I got my co-host Danger Brain here.
Hello.
And we've got our other co-host here, Allison, to join us.
Hey.
We all sat down and we watched the shit fest that is Over the Top with Sylvester Stallone, who also was one of the screenwriters.
You don't say.
You don't say. I know. What movie is he not involved with where he's involved with the writing? You can talk to the director, Judge Dredd, for that one. Lots of problems behind the scenes. So, Over the Top, it's about a horrible father who... It demonstrates in every scene how horrible of a father he is. I guess he's trying to, or his wife, his ex-wife, is in the hospital dying of some horrible heart condition. And so he's supposed to take the kid to see his mom in the hospital.
So that involves a fucking cross-country trip with Stallone in his Hawkmobile.
Did they ever go into why he was driving him? Because I feel like he could have just gotten on a plane and gone to see her if it was that urgent.
Right, like he did.
Did they ever say why?
Introductions, people. Introductions.
I don't think so. I really don't think he did.
Okay.
Well, there was a conversation between her and Mike, the boy, but I don't remember her saying the reason why Dad needed to.
I think the reasoning is it's a Sylvester Stallone film written by Sylvester Stallone. That's the bad reasoning.
Okay, Stallone's reasoning was that Stallone was the one doing the driving. So he picks him up at the kid's in military school, and he's like graduating military school at the very beginning of the movie, and then. I guess it's the headmaster of the military school brings him into this office and is like, hey, your dad's here, your biological dad, you know, because the kid's like, oh, well, I already got a dad. But it's not his biological dad. It's an old man, Robert Loggia, who's always fucking angry in everything he's in. And he's angry in this, too.
He's the rich millionaire. Stallone's the loner, outsider, truck driver.
Arm
wrestler. Before he even gets into the truck, the kid's sleeve is ripped off. And that's the beginning of his quest.
A taste of things to come.
Anyways.
Well, it takes a minute for this. This kid doesn't accept the fact that Stallone is his father. So Stallone shows him a picture of the wedding picture for the kid's mom and himself. And... I guess that was enough. I guess you are dad. And so he gets into the truck, this raggedy... Danger Brand calls it the Hawkmobile. It's this raggedy, rusted piece of shit 18-wheeler with a weight set inside of it.
Oh, the dude is lifting weights, while he's driving.
One arm, the right, just the righty.
So he's got this shit on lock. He knows he's lifting weights while he's driving. He's going to be fucking arm wrestling throughout this fucking journey. This guy knows what's up. So he already knows he's going to be fucking doing a lot of fucking arm wrestling. So right arm has to be working while he fuck. Aren't these fucking trucks manual?
They're manual.
This is probably unsafe of him to do.
I wonder what else Stallone is doing to work that arm muscle.
Find a lot of lot lizards. Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, so one of the things that happens in this movie, and I was talking about how Stallone is such a terrible father, and it's demonstrated in almost every scene of this movie. There are several times where Stallone takes this kid to truck stops, seedy truck stops, where you know that every single one of those truckers is probably hopped up on meth.
I mean, right. Is this not the prerequisite for a bad encounter?
Oh, many bad encounters.
Many, many bad encounters. So this is just, okay, the setup for terrible times.
Oh, yeah. So the first one they go to, I think they go there for lunch, and they're sitting there eating food, and some some really weird looking guy. He looked like Dog the Bounty Hunter. He comes up and gets Stallone's attention and tells him, "Hey, you know, you're gonna arm wrestle me now." Apparently, Stallone is known throughout truck stops as an arm wrestler.
Oh, he's known. He's known.
Well known.
Well known throughout glory holes in this great state.
Well, they take him over there, and for some reason, everybody in the entire joint just suddenly is all about getting over to this arm wrestling match. And then the kid stays sitting down, and one of the parts that... This is one of the first instances where they allude to child rape or pedophilia in this movie. This big muscle-bound dude comes up and puts his hand on the kid's hand and gives him this creepy grin. And
you know things are not well. You know you have a very perturbed sense of being at this point in time.
That's another thing with this movie is that there's this underlying theme. I don't know if they meant to do this, but there's a lot of instances where they allude that somebody's trying to maybe get with the kid or rape the kid. It was kind of disturbing, actually, like seeing this, especially like the first time I noticed, obviously, was with this big bald dude that comes up and puts his hand on a kid's hand. Why would you do that? What the fuck? Why would you do that to some random child? Just walk up and casually put your hand on his hand. Hey, buddy, take a look. I got some candy in my truck just outside. Want to come out? He didn't say that, but
he might as well have. He totally might as well fucking said that. So then, during these,
Sylvester Stallone, he has this arm wrestling match with Dog the Bounty Hunter, and during the match, now this is another thing that happens throughout the movie. Whenever Stallone is getting into a tough place when he's arm wrestling these guys, he does this thing with his hand where he places his fingers over the guy's thumb and like grips their thumb, and then it suddenly gives him a burst of strength.
Don't forget the backwards hat tilt.
Oh yeah, the backwards hat tilt, which he explains later in the movie about how when he turns his hat backwards, the switch. Yes.
So he always switches it before he has these encounters, which, I mean, it's like the worst episode of fucking Dog the Bounty Hunter you've ever seen, or Bloodsport, or the worst fucking martial arts movie. I mean, denigrated and fucking brought below what you'd expect. Like, this is horrible. This movie's stupid. Well, I mean, it's like a martial arts tournament without the martial arts.
Exactly.
So, I don't know how to explain it, but that's the dumbest thing ever. Anyways, right, he tried to fucking put his hand into a position.
What were we calling that when we were watching the movie? What did you call it? You gave it a name.
The hot dog fucking...
It was the hot dog something.
Right. Oh man.
I don't remember what it was. Yeah. We'll remember.
Where'd the hot dog thing come from?
I don't know.
How did that come into your mind?
I don't know, but it was
his
funny.
His fingers go up and then wrap around against the window.
He wraps his fucking fingers around this dude's fucking thumb.
Like he's gonna jerk his thumb off.
My question right. is though, where did you get hot dog from?
Because his fucking hand looks like that dude's fucking thumb. It's a hot dog. It's weird.
Dog the Bounty Hunter has hot dog thumbs.
Anyways, these guys are all fucking crazy looking. They're meth addicted pieces of shit.
Oh yeah, these are the worst of the worst. All these guys are. Actually, throughout this whole movie, everybody that he runs into at these arm wrestling competitions and stuff are all just the kind of people you would see on Cops being chased down.
Before Cops was neutered.
Yeah, exactly. So he does this thing, grabbing hold of the guy's thumb, and then he gets this burst of strength. And not to mention, remember, he's got his hat turned around, like he says later in the movie, that's like him turning into a machine. Like he's a truck. Like
right.
He turns his hat around, he's another man.
He's totally going to be this machine. He's going to be a Mack truck as he arm wrestles these people. Let me tell you what. This guy is half the size of everybody he meets up with in this arm wrestling tournament. The saddest part is he actually is like totally gung-ho. And he's like, hey, let's go for it. He loses once or twice, I think.
Yeah, he loses to the guy that's drinking the oil.
He drinks motor oil. This is the weird part about it. He loses to him first, and then the guy drinks motor oil later, and then he wins against him. So the guy's obviously weakened.
The guy had heartburn, man. He was drinking Alka-Seltzer.
He's weakened from drinking the fucking Valvoline.
That's towards the end.
That is towards the end.
So he loses.
Where do we leave off?
This is the end.
Let's go back.
This is where the kid realizes that his biological father is trolling. Truck stops to arm wrestle big meth addicted truckers.
Yeah, he tries to fucking enlist his son into an arm wrestling battle with fucking John Connor's friend. So basically what we have here is a arm wrestling battle among kids instigated by a deadbeat father. So what we got here is a couple kids fighting out on a pinball machine.
Was it pinball or was it?
It was a pinball. It was a pinball machine.
They're at the restaurant and this kid, challenges Stallone's son to an arm wrestling match, and this kid is at least two times bigger than Stallone's kid. There's no way Stallone's kid would win this match, and he doesn't. He loses the first one. And by the way, the kid that he arm wrestles is the most intense, crazy fucking kid I've ever seen on the movie. He's got some serious issues.
He has a very serious game face going on.
That is an understatement. And Sylvester Stallone's kid loses the arm wrestling match, and he cries. He's upset, because he thinks Stallone was setting him up for embarrassment. Because at this point, he's not completely sold on Stallone, and just him being a dad, and he's still kind of upset that his dad, abandoned him when he was a child.
That will set off some serious fucking emotional spectrums in your mind. But, yeah, you know what? This is the weirdest thing about this movie. Stallone didn't have a lot of part in this kid's life. He was apparently deadbeat. He let these guys go.
Yeah, he...
Way early on.
Well, I mean, as the story goes, is that he left when, I guess, was it before the kid was born?
No, well,
or was it like right after he was born?
He's 12 in the movie, and at the very beginning, he says to his dad, "You can't make up for 10 years in 3 days."
Okay,
so I think when he was two.
So 2 years old.
Yeah.
But they never went into the backstory about that either. All we know is that he left them.
Yeah.
Like nobody
knows
why.
Yeah.
What happened, so...
Either way, it's kind of fucked up that this guy hasn't called and sent a birthday card, anything, and then just pops in and says, "Hey, come with me on this arm wrestling competition."
Well, if they had filled in that part of the plot, it might have made more sense.
Yeah,
but they left it out.
They left it all out.
There was a lot of leave out.
There was a lot of leave out.
A lot of stuff that doesn't make sense.
Well, Stallone has this pep talk with his son outside the diner after he loses this arm wrestling match. And, it's the basic kind of... You could have seen this in a Rocky film. You put in effort, and you're going to get it. You got to believe it. You got to believe in yourself.
Go ahead and move forward,
The kid goes back inside and... He has another round.
He does the hot dog thingy, right?
He does the hot dog thing. Yeah, he does exactly what Dad showed him. And he kicks this kid's ass. And, of course, the kid thinks he was cheating and everything, which I don't really see that as cheating. I see that as anything.
Hold on. Let's be real here. The fact of the matter is, you got this mulleted, rat-tailed kid. He is going to win. If you're going to try to challenge a rat tailer, you have to know what the costs are.
A rat tailer. I'm going to remember that.
He gets sent out, and he has this talk with Stallone. He has this bring-to-life fucking talk. Cathartic talk, I'd say. He ignored the fact that his mom was dying. And he said, "Hey, guess what? I'm going to beat this guy, no matter what." Stallone brought him to that. Right?
Yep.
And I guess if anyone could, Stallone will.
Rocky can do it.
I mean, if you're going to give someone a fucking absolutely retarded speech that makes you want to fucking win a battle, Stallone's there for you. But, yeah, when we watch this and we, like, examine it and we realize, like, this guy lost so, like, easily to this kid and then came back after a Stallone speech and then won.
A Stallone speech is basically like eating your Wheaties and injecting steroids into your heart.
eating your Wheaties and injecting steroids into your heart is exactly what this guy would have had to have after losing that badly to this kid. So, anyways, in this is probably the same fucking stage. This is the same stage where Stallone is having the weird dude like grabbing his kid's arm.
Well, it's this. I think it's the same diner or truck stop.
I mean, why is he bringing his kid to these places? Why?
He's just keeping the terrible father syndrome going.
He's got some problems. He's got some method.
And we
issues.
Haven't even gotten to the part where he tries to teach his son to drive by just letting him drive an 18-wheeler. He's never driven a car before. Set him in the seat.
Kid drive his 18-wheeler without fucking... I mean, obviously you need to learn how to shift and do a lot of shit.
They have schools for that.
They do have schools
for that. Not for that kid, though. He's right? In military school.
It's Sylvester Stallone school. He can teach you to do anything. He can teach you to overcome any dragon or any obstacle just by giving you a pep talk.
Well, so he can scream in your face and let you learn about a lot of things.
But it comes in handy later when he... tries to find his dad and he steals the car.
It does. You
know.
Yeah.
And suddenly, that would never have happened if that hadn't happened.
And let's not forget, he stows away on an airplane and suddenly makes it to this arm wrestling competition in record time.
Okay, yeah.
Right when they make it to the finals.
Great. Yeah. Beat him there, though. And he just had time to get in a hotel room.
Yeah, and have a chat with Stallone.
Okay, I mean, so we're glossing over a couple points. You know, Stallone apparently cares about this kid a lot. He chased him across the highway.
They bond.
They bonded. There was some bondage.
He chased him across the highway so he wouldn't die.
Yeah. He was... I mean, okay, so he cares about the kid.
He didn't start caring about him until later.
Yeah,
that's true.
Didn't care
about him.
He just wanted to get him to mom.
It's questionable.
There's some care there. I mean, he might be an alcoholic, drunken, truck driving.
Is he an alcoholic?
Crazy.
He has to be.
The way I view him,
they did not. I he didn't seems see him like drink it. Once.
No, he wasn't drinking. Although he acted like
he brought this kid in so many pubs.
Yeah, but Sylvester Stallone always sounds drunk.
That's true. He does.
I think he wrote on that. I think he wrote on that for this movie. In a lot of ways, but I also feel like, hey, you know what? You know what? This is a fucking redeemable character. He was redeemable, no matter how much shit he fucking threw out there.
I don't think he was redeemed, but he is redeemable.
Maybe he was.
Well, he won an arm wrestling tournament, and then suddenly everything's better.
Son. You know what?
But his son stole a car and stowed on a plane to get to him, and then got there and was
the
like, oh,
worst
Dad, you
characteristics
won. Good for you.
Yeah, the worst characteristics get played out by the second generation man, I think. A lot of times.
Oh, so you're saying the son will be the alcoholic.
The son was the fucked up one. Man, you know what? Man, Stallone wasn't even as fucked up as his son was. That's the weirdest thing.
He was quite a brat.
He was a brat, yeah. Like, at the beginning, he was just thinking he knew it all. Like, oh, and what was with that whole nutritional shit he was going on about at the very beginning and then just suddenly stopped? Like, they were eating lunch and he's going off about how chicken is going to make give you cholesterol and all this.
Yeah, he got into this whole tangent and he was like, hey, yeah, you know what? And then I'm pretty sure after all the whole tangent, Stallone was like, okay, I can bring you to McDonald's. I can bring you over to McDonald's if you want. I'm like, whoa, that will appease that kid.
Yeah.
Totally.
Because McDonald's is so much healthier for you than chicken.
that would make that kid happy after that tangent.
Maybe he wanted their chicken.
I mean, maybe he's been licking chicken.
Maybe he's just a dick.
Maybe he's been looking some dick chicken. Fuck this movie. Fuck everything this movie stands for. God damn
it. Well, this movie tries to stand for, like, you know, it tries to...
No, everything in this is
message, but the message is not
a friendly message. But
the message is not executed well in the least.
It makes you want to just slit your fucking throat.
What's the message?
Throat slitting.
That deadbeat dads can be good too.
Yeah, deadbeat dads who do bad things after they're assessed as being deadbeat dads can go ahead and fucking slam through people's gates. And just be a dick.
Oh yeah, let's talk about Grandpa. We haven't talked about Grandpa.
Oh yeah, Grandpa Robert Loggia, the angry Grandpa, he was the husband of the current husband of the kid's mom.
No, he was her dad.
Oh, he was her dad. Oh, see, I totally missed that.
Yeah.
apparently, they had been aloof about every Stallone's dealing, all the Stallone's dealing. And we're like, hey, guess what? This guy was a ex-cocaine fucking dealer.
Who?
Who?
Stallone.
Stallone was an ex-dealer?
In real life, yeah.
I thought we were talking about Grandpa.
Oh, okay. I thought we were talking about Grandpa, too.
Grandpa had valid reasons to be
a cocaine addict.
He wasn't a cocaine dealer in the movie.
No, he wasn't a cocaine dealer in the movie.
Okay, fine.
Really,
fine.
In real life, an ex-cocaine dealer?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
I didn't know that either.
Maybe he doesn't. Maybe he's lying.
I don't know. Maybe.
I'll have to look that up.
I don't know. Stallone had some hard times.
I'm a Stallone fanatic.
Stallone had some hard times before Rocky, so I wouldn't put it past him.
Let's cut back.
Wait. No, keep it all. I can cut the stuff out. Remember, I can cut all this stuff out. No worries.
What are we cutting out?
The Stallone being a...
No, don't worry. I can cut that out.
I think I'm wrong.
I don't know.
That's okay.
I wouldn't be surprised if he did. But, okay, so... Now, another little factoid about this movie that's kind of funny is that apparently the producer of the film, Stallone wasn't involved with it until the producer just, I guess he kept on offering him more and more money, and Stallone was like, okay, why not? Nobody's going to see this anyway. And he was wrong, because we've seen it, and millions of other people have seen it since 1987. And we've seen it in all of its glory. All of its meth-addled, bad dad glory.
Meth-addled!
Horrible father-having glory. So, throughout this film, Stallone is proven time and time again that he is not a good father.
Meth addled and crazy on the road.
And possibly addicted to lot lizards.
He's fucked up.
Oh my god.
And so we end up getting to a point where they take the grandpa, you know, he sends somebody out to get the kid back from Stallone. And we have this chase scene where Stallone's chasing after the kidnappers.
Well, these people grabbed the kid and threw him into a car. That's terrifying. Like, what kind of grandpa?
Why wouldn't
he just come get him himself?
You guys are way out. I understand. Where are you guys at? Okay.
We're at the kidnapping.
Whoa, kidnapping? The first kidnapping. Okay.
There's only one.
There was only the one kidnapping.
Well, these guys are some pretty fucked up people.
Well, yeah. Well, I mean, they were like hired gun, like, you know, like thugs.
So why all the kidnappings?
There's only one kidnapping.
Well, the one kidnapping was when the grandpa sent
Stallone
these guys
Stallone kidnapped the kid, though.
No, he didn't kidnap the
kid. Stallone kidnapped that kid.
Well, no, Stallone didn't kidnap the kid.
He was going from school to school.
Oh my God.
Trying to fucking figure out which kid would be as gullible as this kid was.
Yeah.
He picked this kid
and
up.
And he finally got the kid. Oh yeah, I'm your mom's ex-husband. I'm your dad.
He picked him up randomly.
We got one!
So life goes on. Anyways, go on. Sorry.
Okay, so anyway, the kidnapping. The grandpa sends these guys after Stallone because apparently he wants to have the kid. He thinks he should have the kid instead of Stallone, because the mother dies in the in the hospital from her heart condition. And
he has him kidnapped before she even dies.
Was that before? I thought it was after.
No, it was before.
Oh, okay, that was important. See, this grandpa's fucked up, too.
That's what I said. We're going on about how Sylvester Stallone's character is such a bad father, but grandpa sends
a bunch of thugs
to kidnap his grandpa to bring him back. It doesn't...
Yeah, he has these thugs come to kidnap his grandson to bring him back. And I really don't get what was going through the guy's brain. I mean, he could have just talked to Stallone. Maybe.
Nobody can just talk. Nobody can just talk to Stallone. I'm sorry. Well, that's the worst reasoning point you can ever think of. So there.
Well, because Stallone's going to bash their brains in. Or, well, in this movie, in this case, he'll arm wrestle you to death. Because he's shown that he's not a badass in this movie. When he tries to get the kid back from the grandpa, and he busts through the house with his truck, he busts through their front gate and a wall in the house to get
the kid. A couple statues, yeah.
Exactly.
Well, and they should have just let him in.
Well, yeah, the gate guards would not let him in.
I think the exact quote is, you're not welcome here.
Yeah, you're not welcome here. I think he said that like 3 times to him. So he just busts through the gate and the front gate and the wall of the house.
And the door.
The door.
Just
a couple of statues. Just took it all out and then gets out and is like, yeah. Gets out and is like, yeah, Michael, come with me. And he's surprised that they call the cops and don't want him there. Well, you know, in any other Stallone movie, he would have pulled out a gun and started gunning people down and just taking his kid. But in this one, he waits for the cops to come and then he gets arrested and thrown in jail.
I mean, that's kind of actually impressive. They actually demonstrated the factualities of that incident that would have occurred.
That he would have been arrested?
Yeah. It's kind of cool, honestly, with a Stallone film like this.
It's definitely out of the
ordinary. It was different.
Yeah, definitely.
So, but what do we have after that? What happened?
Well, he's in jail, and then they have like some representative, the family,
the attorney.
The grandpa has the attorney come in
and tell him if he leaves the state, they won't prosecute.
Mm-hmm.
If he leaves the state, they won't prosecute. Okay.
But he can't have any contact with Michael.
Yeah, he's also got to sign custody over of Michael, which he agrees to. And then he was going to leave the state anyway. He was going to Nevada for this international arm wrestling competition. Only for truck drivers.
A very serious thing.
Which one of the prizes is a brand new 18-wheeler. If you lived in Japan, if you were one of these guys from Japan or like India, how the hell are you going to get an 18-wheeler overseas? It's going to cost so much money just to have a container ship. Take it across the ocean and take it to your home so you can drive your route in India or Japan. I guess I'm sure they got truck driving routes there too.
So pretty much it's a self-defeating prophecy. Fair.
Whoever came from an international area to come to this arm wrestling contest is a fucking idiot. Plain and simple. They should have stayed in their own country and did an arm wrestling competition there.
I mean, you could have. If you were Shenmue, you could find somebody who did that. Like, right?
Well, possibly.
I mean, if you were Ryu Hazuki from Shenmue, you could... Eventually, you'd make money from it, but...
Well, and another thing is, okay, Stallone gets to this international event, and I still can't believe I'm calling it that. And
It was an event.
It was an international event, and
it's
every
world
single
arm wrestling championship or something.
Yeah,
like
it's like
that.
The world arm wrestling championships. And
they had people from Tokyo,
France,
the world. Mm-hmm.
And he gets there, and every single one of these contestants is absolutely insane.
I think there was one that was smaller than him.
You're right.
I think there were like two.
And there was a woman arm wrestling with a bunch of dudes too,
wasn't
and she was yeah.
I'm
she
sure it wasn't a man.
She was. It was totally a woman. And she actually beat several guys.
I think she was Sarah Connor. Sarah Connor.
Sarah Connor training for Terminator 2.
She was training for that fucking role.
Oh, dude, she even had the pink headband that Sarah Connor has at the end of Terminator 1. It probably was her.
Probably.
The girl with the pink headband was arm wrestling women.
Oh, she was arm wrestling
women? Yeah, there was a women's side.
Well, maybe I just thought that they were men.
Well, I think the full brunt of power they put on Nagasaki would have been adept for this fucking occasion. Kill them all, please. This is the worst movie. This is such a bad movie.
Well, some of these people you couldn't kill with a nuclear blast, because I think some of these people were born from a nuclear blast.
Jesus Christ. So what we have here is a post-apocalyptic movie of fucking cretins and bad people.
There is literally a guy in this that drinks Valvoline motor oil in between matches. What the fuck?
Well,
he looks like he's on PCP the whole time. Like, he's got the crazy... Actually, everybody here had the crazy eyes.
If you've been through the kind of shit he's been through, man, you gotta fucking grease your valves. The kind of shit he's been through, man, he's gotta grease your valves. Okay, so, I mean, that was weird. I agree. That was fucking strange to watch.
The guy fist fights with dinosaurs on the weekends.
He's been in so many B movies that it'll make your fucking head spin.
It already made it spin. That's why he's drinking Valvoline. He's got to grease the gears. But yeah.
So he's a bad human being.
So a lot of the guys that are in this, I read many of them are pro wrestlers, so it kind of explains why they're nuts. And I would not be surprised if almost every man in this entire competition is juicing. Hardcore. Like, I mean, they're literally... In fact, I don't even think that it was oil, motor oil in that Valvoline container. I think it was human growth hormone that he was drinking. Just slurping it up.
Well, so, I mean, I think you missed it, but there were several shots where they were just, like, laid out. Fucking had IVs in their arms, awaiting their fucking growth hormone to come in.
Whilst smoking methamphetamine.
You missed it. Yeah, you must have missed it, but there was plenty of that. So
completely insane competition with rejects from a post-apocalypse film is going on, and Stallone is working his way up the ranks. You know, he's beating guys left and right until he makes it to, you know, nutcase man that drinks motor oil, and he
blaster.
Loses that.
Oh, wait,
he
loses blaster, that match. Blaster.
No, Blaster's the big guy. You know, he's the last guy. One. Yeah, okay. He's the big last guy. That's his nemesis. That's his dragon that he must slay. You know, because Stallone's always got to have a dragon to slay, whether it be Ivan Drago or Blaster. And he loses to Valvoline Head. And this is at the point where the grandpa has shown up via private jet. And he is now there to have a discussion with Stallone.
So he has a meeting with Stallone. He brings up to his private VIP office. I'm pretty sure Stallone...
The presidential suite.
Yeah, it's the president. Yeah,
the presidential suite. Stallone gets pretty upset by the conversation and destroys this guy's fucking sliding glass doors. Slams him open with his two fists.
He tries to bribe him.
Yeah, he tries to bribe him with like $500,000.
Wait, okay, $500,000 and his own truck.
Right, he wants to give him what he would win in the contest.
Yeah.
So he was
without the child.
But without the child, yeah.
So, I mean, this is all pretty creepy. This is all kind of weird.
They're basically selling a child back and forth.
They figure Stallone's such a bad dad at this point. They're like, you know what? He wants his dad, though. So we're going to bribe you, and we're going to try to set it up so that you can be a good dad. He's like, I don't get this. I'm not.
that's literally what we were all thinking too. We were all on the same page as Stallone, because I mean the old man had basically won at this point. He'd already won. He had custody. Stallone left the state, and the kid was the one that ran off. to go to this competition to catch up with Stallone.
And magically got there on time.
After stealing a car from his grandpa's house and stowing away on an airplane.
He exhibited every fucking antisocial behavior.
When he got on the truck that transports the baggage.
Yes. He jumped the baggage truck to truck.
He just jumped on it and put a suitcase over him.
Nobody would catch that. That's you hiding?
Well, I figured maybe he jumped from truck to truck and there was some Mad Max scene I fucking didn't watch. That'd be awesome.
That all happened off
keep
camera.
Keep it in your imagination. Whatever you think happened, that happened.
He had a whole nother movie that we didn't see. So he gets there. The kid gets there, at the perfect time, of course. And it's like right before the finals, I think. And this is also after Grandpa has his conversation with Stallone, where he's trying to bribe him for no fucking reason at all.
He wants to keep the kid. He doesn't want him in his life.
Yeah, he doesn't want him in his life, but it's like, you've already won. Yeah, he's already got custody legally.
I think if Michael hadn't ran away from home to find Dad, then he wouldn't have done that.
Yeah.
But you don't have Stallone's muscles in the equation. As soon as you have that...
Oh, the old man was afraid of the muscles.
Doors breaking open, there's going to be like, hey, this isn't happening. There's going to be people in terror running in the streets. Falsified prophecies. People screaming.
Dogs and cats living together. Mass hysteria.
Well, obviously he knew he was going to win. He bet on himself.
Yeah. Yeah, he did. I think he knew he had in the bag. He beats the other guys leading up to his nemesis, Blaster.
I think it's Smasher.
No, it's Blaster. Smasher was the first guy. Beat Smasher.
Yeah, beat Smasher. Smasher's
the guy from the truck stop.
Okay. He's the guy that looks like Dog the Bounty Hunter. Yeah.
Okay.
It's Dog the Bounty Hunter before he went to prison and became a... And then got out and then became a bounty hunter. So, hard times.
Dog went to prison?
Yeah.
Really?
He was like way into drugs and everything, and then he went to prison, and then when he got out, he became clean and became a bounty hunter.
Hmm.
This is the hard times for Dog.
Okay, so this is his lowest point.
This is his lowest point, yeah. This is before he had a turnaround. He was on lots of meth at this point.
He had his troubles.
Oh, and another thing about this arm wrestling competition, if we were to do cut up video of all the funny faces these guys make during this competition, it would be epic.
That would be the YouTube sensation.
Oh, absolutely. This would be hilarious. The faces these guys make, it looks like they got a poop, but it's not coming out. And they're trying so hard.
You should do that. You should make a little video of all the faces. That would be fun.
I might do that, actually. That's a good idea. I think that would be great. That'd be a good...
Do it in slow motion.
Too. Yeah, that would be a great little companion piece to this episode. So, we get to Blaster. We get the final battle between Stallone's dragon, Blaster, and, of course, Stallone, who is like... Blaster is like 2 times bigger than Stallone. You could tell in real life, if this was a real match, Blaster would ruin Stallone. He'd break his fucking arm into oblivion. But it's Stallone in a movie. There's no way Blaster has a chance. And they go back and forth for a minute, and then their hands slip off. So the referees then tie their hands together so that they can't do that again. And they go again, and they're pushing. Oh, it's back and forth. It keeps you on the edge of your seat watching these guys try not to poop. and then finally, after back and forth for a couple of minutes, Stallone does what he always does to win: the secret thumb technique.
The hot dog thingy.
And grabs hold of this guy's thumb, and watch how quickly it turns around. Within seconds of doing that, this guy's eyes widen, and he's like, oh God, what do I do? Getting pushed down, and Stallone just murders him with no problem whatsoever. It makes me wonder, why didn't Stallone do that from the get-go? If this secret weapon is so all-powerful, why did he not just switch it over and let the magic happen.
Well, because he obviously wants to allow the other person a sense of ability, a sense of...
He doesn't want to make them feel bad.
He doesn't. He's giving them the sympathy card.
He wants to give a good show to the audience. That's
so. What, but yeah. He's like, hey, guess what? No matter what, if your arm is twice the size of mine, I know I'll beat you anyways.
The guy he had to beat to get to Boster, he beat within like 2 seconds.
Yeah, that was the black dude. Yeah, the guy that we thought looked like Lando Calrissian.
Yeah, Lando Calrissian.
The guy looked just like Billy Dee Williams, except for with lots of muscles. If Billy Dee Williams were to be doing steroids for about 8 months and doing nothing but powerlifting, that's what this guy looks like.
That's what we'd have.
He's pretty small.
Huh?
He looked pretty small to me.
Yeah?
Yeah.
He's bigger than Stallone.
Really? Yeah.
So this movie was an absolute atrocity.
It was an atrocity.
I thought it was kind of cute.
It had its moments. You
know, Allison liked the movie.
Yeah.
Lots of plot holes.
Lots of plot holes.
Lots of things that did not make sense at all.
As I thought, she feels like it's charming in a way. But.
But I love Sylvester Stallone too, so.
Well, it's a good thing I look like Sylvester Stallone. Hey,
I love Sylvester Stallone too. I think he's great, but this is one of those movies where it's not a high watermark for him.
It's very upsetting to watch this film, actually.
Most
in a personal level, and not even an actioner fucking Sylvester Stallone fanatic way. This movie is disturbing to watch in different ways that make you wonder about why the hell do they make movies in the first place.
Do you
place?
Really feel that way?
I am, yeah, why to my core.
Why do you watch that movie so much then? Why do you force people to watch it?
That's probably why he forces people to watch it.
I think you secretly love it. He's a closet over-the-top fan.
The most horrible way, I think it's inflicting torture on people, but... I mean, most people think it's funny enough to talk shit about it, so I think we had a good time.
It's a good icebreaker for when you bring people over that you're not so sure about, and everyone's sitting there all awkward. You know, nobody really knows each other. Oh, I'll turn on Over the Top and just get people to laugh.
You have a couple people walking out. You have a couple people being like, "I love Stallone." Yeah. You have a couple people being like, "What the fuck are you watching right now?" And you have a couple people like who are like, "Hey, we'll do a podcast with you."
And that's that was me. Us.
That's me, my friend, that was Kevin, and Allison.
And we didn't talk about the ending. The kid comes running up after he wins, and Stallone lifts him up, and they hug, and it's, you know, the whole, they win the day. It was like Rocky, the end of Rocky, except for without Talia Shire running up.
So,
it's the kid running up and hugging, like, "Michael, I did it!"
So, Stallone's character.
"You did
character.
It, Dad!" And then he magically has custody of him after
that. After that,
Stallone's character
has custody.
Yeah.
None of the other problems we talked about.
Slamming into gates with a Mack truck, you know, going in and screaming at family members, going in and ripping someone's sleeves off.
He didn't yell. He was very calm.
Oh, he was calm.
He's a very calm character.
After he slammed through their gate and their door.
Oh, I guess he yelled for Michael.
Yeah. He yelled for Michael.
Michael! Yeah! I thought you were here, you know? You're not here? You had a sleepover? Oh, shit.
Wrong house.
I'll run back out.
Wrong house. Sorry. I won't pay for that dog.
Okay.
I have no money. I'm a trucker. I spent it on lot lizards.
Bottom line short, this movie was god-awful. I mean, if you want a nostalgia trip from the 80s, you can watch it.
Oh, the music.
Oh
my God.
We didn't talk about the music.
Gio Gregorio was the piece of...
Gio Gregorio. Oh, man. This guy's name is always going to be a problem. Giorgio, right? Yeah.
Okay,
we call him Gio Gio.
We've called him several things.
Several things, except for Shirley. He surely sucks. This film was god-awful garbage, sewer water up to the fucking waist. This makes me want to fucking die in a fucking blood vomit fucking spastic fit. I hate this film, and all my friends I've ever watched it with hate it too. So, if you're going to watch this, it's going to be an ironic factor. But oh, you're gonna
absolutely.
But yeah. You're going to hate yourself afterwards. And I will tell you right now that this film is Stallone's worst movies ever made. One of his worst movies ever made.
I agree. It is one of his worst movies. The music is terrible. It's like the worst kind of 80s music. The movie itself, the character is not really redeemed at all. He's still a horrible father. Nothing's really resolved. It's just everybody just forgets about everything and they move on. That's it.
That's it. That's it. The guy starts off as a bad father. He ends the film as a bad father. And unless you're a fucking aficionado of arm wrestling and you feel like this guy redeemed himself through arm wrestling, then you really didn't fucking get shit from this movie. You want to kill yourself way farther.
Nobody redeems himself through arm wrestling.
Yeah, you want to put the gun in your mouth after this movie. So that's where I feel... By the way,
maybe the grandpa put a gun in his mouth. That's why we didn't hear anything more about
it. I mean, okay, so the grandfather was probably the most redeeming character after all this fucking said is done. He didn't do that bad.
He was actually a normal guy.
He didn't seem that bad. He was the enemy of the movie, and he didn't seem that bad.
Really wasn't that bad of an enemy, yeah. He seemed pretty logical, and everything that he was trying to do made a lot of sense.
So just kill yourself if you watch this, is my main... thing. And what do you guys, any follow-ups or?
Well, I'd have to agree on a lot of things there, because like it is a terrible movie. It's a movie you watch with people to make fun of, because it's not a good movie in any way. It is one of Stallone's worst. I do see the charming traits to it. I do see, you know, where people can, you know, they win at the end, you know, everybody's all happy, you know, it's an 80s movie, of course they're going to have that stuff.
It's all about the journey, though.
It's about the journey.
And you know what, the journey in this was,
although I'm not really sure what that journey was.
Stupefying, stupefyingly bad. Stupefyingly bad.
It's considered a sports drama.
I would consider it just like the entrails of a fucking rat that had been ripped out by a hook.
They should have focused more
by
on
a rusty
sport.
Hook.
They only
Sylvester Stallone's character arm wrestles one time before the champion.
You're right.
And
yeah.
That was with
they're really
the guy at the
Yeah, there really isn't a lot of focus on arm wrestling except for the fact that he's trying to get to this arm wrestling competition.
I feel like they could have incorporated it more if they were going to call it a sports drama.
Yeah, they focused a lot more on the drama between the grandpa and the son and Stallone and custody and weird, creepy pedophiles trying to kidnap the child and just...
Yeah, we didn't really go into that, but there's a lot of that, too.
There is an underlying... Yeah, there's a lot of, like, hint, kind of, like, it's this underlying weird... it really is uncomfortable. It's just watch the movie, and it's you'll see what I mean. There is
don't
some
be
kind
telling
of
our viewers
thing.
To watch the movie.
Oh, check it out. You
never
this is a movie.
Just skim through it like you would have. Oh,
yeah, this is a movie
just
you should it, see
like a
at least
into each chapter.
Yeah, you should see this movie at least once just to see how ridiculous this movie is.
I am ready to put a fucking molten hot fucking pellet of bullet in my head after this fucking movie.
So
do not watch this movie. Do not watch this movie. Our job is to tell you to fucking not watch this piece of shit. This movie, you should not see ever. And this, your life will be benefited if you did not ever see this or knew this movie existed.
I will say one thing. The poster looks cool.
It was a cute movie.
I no.
Yes, it was
bad.
Cute. It was cute. I'm not saying it was good, but it
kill
was
it.
Cute.
Kill it.
It's a nice family movie.
So we've got three different ideas here. There's the somewhat
I wouldn't have
more positive.
Paid money to see it in theaters.
Oh no,
but it's not completely awful, is what I'm saying.
Right. Well, there's the somewhat more positive review here. Then there's the middle ground, and then there's the this is absolute horse shit, just mice entrails in a desert, just getting all hot and stinky and nasty and having your face rubbed in them.
You should never see this movie. Please, every viewer, God damn it, go away. Walk away immediately. Please. That's the kind of feel I have. So
you've been warned. Watch this at your own risk, at your own peril.
Might lose some brain cells.
You may lose
some brain cells.
You may lose some brain cells. And do not do what they're doing on the screen. Don't go and drink a thing of Valvoline. Because the guys that are doing it are hopped up on PCP, meth, and probably aren't completely human themselves. So just don't do it. That stuff was not made to drink. There's a reason why it shows the guy later using Alka-Seltzer. I think it must cause really bad heartburn.
Oh, at the very least of fucking your concerns, it's going to liquefy your entrails, motherfucker. Never fucking drink that, and never watch this movie, because it will liquefy your fucking brain. Your life is over when you watch this. Please, God.
Your life is over. You watch Over the Top, and your life will end.
Yeah. Life and misery begin, and never watch it. So we have Dr. Fucking Sleaze.
Danger Brain. Dr. Sleaze, this is Danger Brain.
Danger Brain here.
And we have Allison here, our other host, who is... and we have another host that's also going to be joining us in the next episode as well. So we're going to have a full team of four in the following episodes to come.
You guys ready to arm wrestle?
I am.
We have to listen.
Okay, we're going to proof listen to this piece of shit. And then we have an arm wrestling tournament that's going to occur. And you know who's going to win? I think you do. Danger Brain is going to win.
Well, we gotta move here.
I'm going to... My dick's caught into the fucking computer. Okay. Review.
Wait. All right. Danger Brain versus Dr. Sleaze. Wait.
I feel like this isn't a fair.
I'm doing the thumb.
3, 2, 1, oh, fuck you. Oh, I'll beat you right now. Yeah. Go. Oh, fuck.
I did the thumb thing. It works.
The thumb thing works. He did do the thumb thing, and it did work for him.
It works! Stallone doesn't lie. It works! It's the secret arm wrestling move. You will win every time if you do the thumb thing. All right, guys. Thank you for listening. We will be back again soon with another Video Vagrancy.
Make it right, make it true. You know you got to break.